talking about slope and what it means on two different graphs, distance versus time and velocity versus time. So let's take a look at this graph. We got distance in meters for the y-axis and time in seconds. So if you just arrange them as y over x, which is slope, you get a meter per second, which is velocity. So on a graph of distance versus time, slope is velocity. Okay, let's take a look at the second graph. What's different? This graph, the y-axis is velocity, and time is our x-axis. So again, if you just put your y units divided by your x units, that gives you a feel for what the slope is. So when you have a meter per second, that's a meter per second squared. That's acceleration. So on a graph of velocity versus time, slope is acceleration. What slope means in terms of being positive or negative and curving. So again, look at this graph. We got distance versus time. So we know that. That means slope is velocity. And it's a positive slope the whole way in this region and the second region. But what's different here is it's curving up. And so what we'd like to say is the slope keeps getting steeper. And if you just substitute what slope is, then you'll understand what's happening. Slope is velocity, so the velocity is zero here, and it keeps getting steeper or bigger. So this shows increasing velocity or acceleration. The second part of the graph is a straight line. So again, if slope is velocity and slope is constant, velocity is constant. I'm going to say that again, try to model it for you. So first say slope is constant. What does slope represent? Slope is velocity. And then just put the two together. Velocity is constant. So in this graph, on a distance versus time graph, when you see curving lines, that means there's acceleration. When you see straight lines, that means acceleration is zero. Let's scroll down a bit here and look at this one. Distance versus time still, so slope is velocity. Constant slope, constant velocity. And again, remember it's positive. What's happened here? It's curving. Here it's curving from being steep to where slope is zero. So you can say velocity is big, going to zero. So this shows acceleration, but negative acceleration. It's slowing down. Velocity versus time. So slope is acceleration. And we have three different slopes. We have a positive slope, so you just substitute in acceleration. Positive slope, positive acceleration. Zero slope, zero acceleration. Negative slope, negative acceleration.